Very good morning, students. So today we are going to see about the cost and revenue analysis. Okay? So what do you mean by cost and what do you mean by revenue? So cost means it is a cost means it is an expense which is incurred in the production. Very good morning, students. So today we are going to see about the cost and revenue analysis. Okay, so what do you mean by cost and what do you mean by revenue? So cost means it is a cost means it is an expense which is incurred in the production. Revenue means through the sale of goods we receive an income that is called as a revenue. So today we are going to see about the cost and revenue analysis. So what are the types of costs which are incurred in the production and what are the types of revenue that a producer or an entrepreneur or an owner who receives. Okay, so now we are going to see, already in the last class I have explained about the different types of cost. So again a small recap about the cost. So now we will see what are the basic concepts of cost. So first one, it is a money cost. What do you mean by money cost? So money cost means it is for the production, that is an expense which is incurred in the production, producing and commodity. So in order to produce and commodity, what are the types of cost which has been incurred? It is called as a money cost. So generally to produce one commodity, what are the types of cost will be incurred? For example, rent will be it's an important cost, that is for the land we will be paying as a rent, then labors we will pay as a wages, and then capital as a rent, and then so many expenses are required in order for producing a product. So what are the other remaining costs? So like insurance, tax, electricity bill, petrol, fuels, other miscellaneous expenses which is incurred for the production. So this is called as a money cost. So money cost also has a different name. It also has a varieties of name. So money cost is also called as an explicit cost. It is also called as an implicit cost. It is also called as an out-pocket cost. Okay. Next we come to know about the real cost. What do you mean by a real cost? The effort and sacrifice which an owner has made, it is called as a real cost. Okay, so if land has kept as an empty, it does not have any value. If we utilize the land, so for that land which receives a rent, that is called as a effort and sacrifice. If a labor, he is spending his leisure period, okay, on any work, so he receives a wages, so it is called as a effort and sacrifice. Then a producer, he can sit as an idol, okay? He can sit simply. But what happens? He is putting an effort and sacrifice in order to produce any commodity. So, this is called as a real cost. Next, we come to know about the explicit cost. So, explicit cost means what? Payment made on production of goods. Okay? So, payment made. For what are the things payment has been made? So, explicit cost is also called as a money cost. So, payment is made for the as a wages, rent, interest, like transport, petrol, fuel, taxation, insurance. So, these are all called as an explicit cost. Implicit cost. What do you mean by an implicit cost? Payment made for their own resources which they have used. So it is called as an implicit. Already a producer or a owner who is having his own resources like land, building, machineries, for that what happens, they will just keep certain amount, they will allocate a certain amount. But this amount which is not entered in this regular book account. Okay. So this is implicit cost is also called as a book cost. Okay. Next we come to know about an economic cost. Economic cost means it is a combination, it combines an implicit as well as an explicit. So it just combines both the cost. It is called as an economic cost. So implicit cost and explicit cost. So explicit cost means payment made for the production of goods, and implicit cost means payment made for the own resources. So when we combine both this cost is called as an economic cost. Okay. So next, social cost. Social cost means it is also called as an external cost. That is, a producer who is producing certain commodities, but definitely what happens, he just polluted the environment like the air, water and other things. So for that he has to bear that expense. So that is called as a social cost. Next we come to know about an opportunity cost. A most important one, it is an opportunity cost. Opportunity cost means it is a next best alternative for God. Okay. So a person who is sacrificing for his future or for the best one, that is called as an opportunity cost. See here, in the last class I have explained very clearly. You just go through that video and just look it. Then sunk cost, it is also called as a retrospective cost. Sunk cost means what? That is the past expense which cannot be incurred in the future. See, if we keep on adopting a new technology, we are just spending an expense on the plant or machineries. But in the future, it cannot be replaced because another new technology will be introduced. So that's why they have said that past expense which is not recovered in the future. So this is called as a sunk cost. Next one, it is a floating cost. So floating cost is also another important cost. Okay. So for example, here they have given an example of a floating cost. So purchase of raw materials and so other things. Next we come to know about a prime cost. So prime cost is also a variable cost. So under prime cost, the cost will be keep on changes. Now we come to know the very important cost is the two types of cost. It is, one is a fixed cost and another one is a variable cost. So what do you mean by a fixed cost? So fixed cost means what? Variable cost means what? See, fixed cost means the cost will not change during the production time. So the cost will be fixed. That is, certain cost will be fixed during this production period. The cost will not change. But variable cost means the cost will be keep on changing during this production. So under fixed cost, see, take an example of rent. Okay, so rent will be fixed and it is an will be fixed for its entire production period. So rent is a fixed cost. Taxation is a fixed cost. Insurance is a fixed cost. Then wages, that is permanent workers has a wages. So it is a fixed cost. Okay, so these are the examples for the fixed cost. For the variable cost, the cost will be changes during this production period. For example, petrol will be incurred. So for the first time, the petrol will be fuel surcharges will be increased. The next time, the fuel charge will be reduced. So the cost will be changed. The next example is in raw material. First time when we purchase a raw material, the cost will be one price. Afterwards, what happens again? If we need in raw materials, the price will be keep on changes. So raw material price will be changes, petrol fuels price will be changes, electricity bill price will be changes. So these are the examples of variable cost. Okay. So now we will move to a very important one. It is a short run cost curve. So what do you mean by short run cost curve? So under short run cost curve, so what are the costs which has been incurred? Okay, so see here, first one, so under short run cost curve, what are the types of costs which has been included? So here they have included, first one is a total fixed cost, second one total variable cost, third one total cost, fourth one average fixed cost, fifth one average variable cost, sixth one average cost. Okay, so here they have taken about and six under short time. They have measured about the six cost. So first one is a total fixed cost, total variable cost, total cost, average fixed cost, average variable cost, and average cost. Okay. Now we will see about what is total fixed cost. What is total fixed cost? What is total variable cost? Okay. Let us say total fixed cost means what? Total fixed cost means when we start in production. Okay. So what are the costs? That is fully, it is fully fixed. So the cost will not change during this production period. So the cost will be remains changes for its entire production. For example, rent is a fixed cost. Permanent workers' wages is a fixed cost. Taxation is a fixed cost. Insurance is a fixed cost. Okay, so these are the called as a fixed cost. So now we will see about the total fixed cost. So here they have explained with the help of a table and diagram. So see here the table which is explains. So first one, it is an output total fixed cost. Okay, see when total first one the output is zero. Next 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay, my total cost is first one, it is 1000. So see here, to find the total fixed cost, so first one is an output. So first output is zero and total fixed cost is 1000. So when there is no output, when there is no output, but the expense, the cost which has been incurred in the production is 1000. So when there is no output, how the cost which has been incurred as a 1000? See, before producing and goods, before producing and goods, certain expense which has been made. For example, afterwards only, after producing a goods, after that only we will receive an output. But before that, we using certain inputs. So for that we had spent certain amount. So that amount is called as a fixed cost. So the output is zero, but the total fixed cost. So before producing an output, certain amount which has been spent for the first thing. So one is an rent. So rent is the most important. So rent is a fixed cost. So in the starting itself, rent, then wages will be paid, and then taxation, insurance, everything will be paid. Okay. So if there is no output, but total fixed cost, it is in starting one. So the output will be 1000. Then afterwards, what happened? The output in unit, first unit has been produced. So total fixed cost will not change. So every month the rent will not be changed. So the rent will be a constant one. So taxation will be a constant one. Insurance will be a constant one. So insurance premium will be a constant. Labor's wages, permanent workers' labor's wages is a constant. So what happens when output is keep on increasing means the total fixed cost will not increase, it remains and constant. So in the beginning when there is no output, the output is zero, but even though fixed cost has been made, okay, even though output is zero, so total fixed cost has been made. So like rent, wages, taxations, insurance, etc., which has been paid before itself. When output has been keep on increase means the total fixed cost will not change. So the total fixed cost will remain the same. So see the diagram they have. So here what happens on the x-axis they have taken, on the x-axis they have taken an output and y-axis they have taken as a cost. So y-axis cost and x-axis it is the output. So OX axis represents, at OX axis it represents an output and OY axis it represents as a cost. So now what happens, my total fixed cost 1000. So it is a constant one. When the output is keep on increasing, the total fixed cost which is constant. So what happens? The total fixed cost line will be an horizontal straight line. The total fixed cost which is an horizontal straight line, because the cost is remains the same. Okay. Next we come to know about a total variable cost. Total variable cost means what? So the cost will be changes during the production period. The cost will be keep on changes. For example, electricity, petrols, raw materials, and temporary wages for the laborers. Okay, so other miscellaneous expenses which will be keep on changes. So this is called as a total. It is called as a variable cost. So when we add all the variable costs, it is called as a total variable cost. So it is clear. So total variable cost. First, variable cost means what? The cost will be keep on changing during the production period. So the cost will be changes during this production period. So the starting first in the beginning, the cost will be differ. The next time if you produce, the raw material price will be increased. Petrol price will be increased. Electricity usage will be increased. So the cost will be increased or it might be decreased. So this is called as a variable cost. So when we add all the variable costs, it is called as a total variable cost. So total variable cost, which is explained with the table and diagram. So see here, total variable cost, which is explained through the table, that is schedule. So see here, output in unit and total variable cost. See, when there is no output, see, when the total variable cost in the beginning, when the output is zero, the total variable cost is also will be zero, because the cost which is taken after the production starts. Okay, so after the production starts only the cost will be incurred, that is total variable cost will be incurred. But under total fixed cost, before starting and production, in the beginning itself we have spent certain amount. So in the beginning of total fixed cost, when there is a zero, we have spent there. But the variable cost means after the production only the cost which will be incurred. So see, when there is an output is zero, so total variable cost is also zero, because after the production only the cost will be changes. So when it started for the first unit, the cost started to change. So next one, when two, second unit, when the output is two, see, the total variable cost has been started to increase. When we producing the third unit, the cost has started to increase. When we started to produce fourth, the output cost has been started to increase. So when output started to increase, our cost also started to increase. So this is called as a total variable cost. So with the help of an schedule, we are going to draw a diagram. So see here, under x-axis they have taken as an output, under y-axis they have taken as a cost. So see the numbers numerical work, that is they have taken from 200. So you also have take as a measure 200, 400, 600, 800, then 1000. Now plot it. So under unit 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay. So now first one, the output, when the output is 0, so the total variable cost which is incurred is also 0. So when the output started to produce, so when the output is 1, so what happens to the total variable cost? When the output is 1, the total variable cost is 200. Next one, when the output is 2, the total variable cost is 300. So just before 200 to 300, 400, we will be having. Next one, when the third output, what is the total variable cost? So when we come to the fourth unit, total variable cost is 600. When comes to the fifth unit, it is between 800 to 9000 we will be having a 900. So the diagram plotted all the lines and then join all those lines. So the diagram will be like this. So this is our total variable cost. So see like this. So total variable cost. So is it clear? See, total fixed cost and total variable cost. Fixed cost means the cost which will be remains constant. So the cost does not change. So it will not change during the production period. So example for fixed cost is rent, wages, then taxation, insurance premium. So these are the example for total fixed cost. Variable cost means the cost which will change during the production period. So the cost will be keep on changes. That is called as a variable cost. So total fixed cost means entirely we have to calculate all the fixed cost, and total variable cost means we have to calculate all the variable cost. So it is called as a total fixed cost and total variable cost. So when we come to know about the output and the total fixed cost, even a production starts, the amount which has been spent is 1000. Okay? But under the variable cost, even there is a no production, so the variable cost does not incur, because this is incurred after the production starts. Okay? So it is zero, so that's why the total variable cost is also zero. But under fixed cost, so when there is a zero output, but fixed cost will be incurred before the production. Okay, right? Okay. Now we will see about the total cost. So total cost means what? It combines the total fixed cost as well as total variable cost. It is called as a total cost. So total fixed cost and total variable cost, which is added, it is called as a total cost. So see here. So total cost means it is the total fixed cost plus total variable cost we will be getting as a total cost. Okay. So now what happens? So now, let us see about the total cost. So total cost means it is combined the total fixed cost and total variable cost we will be getting as a total cost. So see the output. When the output is zero, our total fixed cost is 1000, but the total variable cost is zero. So before the production start, we have spent certain amount, okay, like rent, wages, taxation, insurance. So that is called as a total fixed cost. So but total variable cost is zero when there is no output. So when there is no output, but if so, total variable cost will be zero, because total variable cost, which is income after the production. So now total cost means it is combined, the total fixed cost plus total variable cost we will be getting as a total cost. So total fixed cost plus total variable cost we will be getting total cost. So total fixed cost is 1000, but no total variable cost when there is no output, so output is zero, so total cost is 1000. Next one, when we started, that is the first unit has been produced, so total cost is 1000, so total cost will be common, it will not change, but total variable cost will be changes. So now if we add 1000 plus 200, total variable cost under second unit of output is 1200. So third unit, the total cost is 1300, and the fourth unit, the total cost is 1400. Then under fifth one, 1600. Then under fifth unit, the total cost is 1900. Okay. So with the help of this total cost alone, we have to take it and we have to draw the graph. So see here, they have taken the x-axis and y-axis. So take like this and started to draw. First one, we have to draw the total fixed cost, total variable cost, and then total cost. Okay. So it is combined. The line will be, we have a three joint line. Okay. So first one, see the total fixed cost. So the total fixed cost at the output is. So our x-axis represents output and y-axis represent cost. So take it as a unit. So as a 200, so now we are going to see about the total cost. Okay, so this is called as a total cost. So x axis, 0 to x axis represents output, and 0 to y axis represent as a cost. So take it as in the manner, the unit 200, 400, 600, 800, 1000, 1200, 1400, like that. Okay, so up to 2000 you take it, because see the total cost, which is the last number, is 1900. Okay, now that we should draw. So how to draw means, first we have to draw the total fixed cost, then we have to draw the total variable cost, then we have to draw the total cost. So first we draw the total fixed cost. So when the output is zero, the total fixed cost is 1000. So the cost line will be straight horizontal. So total fixed cost will be horizontal straight line. Now we will move to the total variable cost. So when the output is zero, so from here we have to start from the zero axis. Then from 1 it is 200. So from 1 it is 200 to it is 300. 600, then 5, it is 900. Okay, so join all those lines as like this. Next one, we have to draw the total cost. So total cost means when the output is 0, so start from here, when the output is 0, the total cost is 1000. So straight line. Okay, next one, when the output is 1, what is the total cost? When the output is 1, the total cost is 1200. When the output is 2, the total cost is 1300. When the output is 4, sorry, when the output is 3, the total cost is 1400. Then when output is 4, the cost is 1600. 5, the cost is 1900. So total cost, total fixed cost and total variable cost. Okay, so it is clear. So see, total cost means it combines the total fixed cost and total variable cost. So see the table, so total cost, when the output is 0, so output 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, okay. Now total fixed cost is 1000. So before the production starts, the expense which has been incurred, like rent, wages, taxation, insurance premium, etc. Total variable cost, when the output is 0, but total variable cost is 0, because total variable cost which is incurred after the production, so it will be 0. So total cost means it is combination, it combines the total fixed cost and total variable cost. So total fixed cost and variable cost, so when the output is 0, even though a producer spent 1000 rupees, it is your total fixed cost. When there is an output, when the output is 1, the total cost is 1200. So total fixed cost plus total variable cost, we will be getting total cost. So when it is a fifth unit, see that total cost is 1900. So the diagram, 0 to x axis represent output and 0 to y axis represent cost. So here, now what happens, we have to draw the three costs. Total fixed cost, variable cost and total cost. So total fixed cost will be, it's an horizontal straight line. So horizontal straight line means because the total fixed cost is a constant one. So the constant one means the cost line will be an horizontal. Next one, what happens, total variable cost. So here it's a total variable cost and here it is combined the total cost. Okay. Next we will see about the average fixed cost and average variable cost and average cost. Okay, so now we will see about the average fixed cost. So average fixed cost means it is combined, that is how to find an average fixed cost. In order to produce one unit of output, how much amount which has been spent, it is called as an average fixed cost. In order to produce one output, okay, one output, so what is the, how much has been spent, it is called as an average, to find the average for one unit of output. So how to find the average fixed cost? So total fixed cost is divided by Q. Divided by Q means it is the number of unit of output produced. So how much of output has been produced? So total fixed cost is divided by Q. We will be getting as an average fixed cost. Okay, so see here, the table explains the output is 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay, so now what happens when the total fixed cost is 1000? So the cost will not change. The cost will not change. The cost will be 1000 itself, because fixed cost will not change. So fixed cost will be remains the same. Now what happens? Average of fixed cost means in order to produce one unit of output, how much has been spent. So it is called as an average fixed cost. So total fixed cost is divided by Q, we will be getting as an average fixed cost. So when there is no output, our output is zero, but even though total fixed cost has been spent. So average of fixed cost, when it has been divided by zero, we will be getting as an infinitive. Okay, when it has been divided into 0 means we will be getting as an infinitive. Now, when the first unit, okay, so we have to find the average. So, in order to produce one unit, we have to find the total, that is average of variable cost. So, in order to produce one unit, how much we have spent alone in the total fixed cost. So, when we saw, that is when the output is 1, the total fixed cost is 1000. So, what is the average fixed cost? So, average fixed cost is 1000. So, 1000 is divided by number of units, we will be getting as a 1000. When comes to the second unit, this total fixed cost is 1000. So when we produce at the second unit, what is the average fixed cost? So average fixed cost means finding, that is in order to produce one unit, how much we have spent. So when it comes to the second unit, how much has been spent? So see here, so how we got the average fixed cost as in 500, 1000 divided by number of unit, that is second unit. So what is the average fixed cost? When it comes to the third unit, so what is our average fixed cost? When it comes to the fourth unit, what is our average fixed cost? Is 250. So when we come to the fifth unit, so our average cost is 200. Okay, so average fixed cost means in order to produce one unit, how much amount has been spent. So how to find the average fixed cost means total fixed cost is divided by Q, we will be getting as an average fixed cost. Okay, so with the help of the average fixed cost, now we are going to draw a diagram. So diagram, so see the diagram. So, x-axis represents output, y-axis represents cost. So, here we see the value, the output is 0, 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. So, see the values of an average fixed cost. Now, we are going to draw average fixed cost, not the total fixed cost. We are going to see the average fixed cost. So, take the value of an average fixed cost. See the values they have taken. See the values. So take it in a manner 200, 400, 600, 800, 1000. So when the unit 0, the output is also 0 only. Okay. When 1, see the 1. When the output is 1, the average fixed cost is 1000. When we started to produce the second unit, the average cost started to decrease. So under 2, the average cost is 500. So between 400 to 600, it will be an 500. When we comes to third one, it is an, when we producing third unit of output, the average cost started to decline. When the output is keep on increasing means the average fixed cost also will be decreased. And the third unit, so between third unit 200 to 400, The next one, when the output is 4, the average fixed cost is 250. Next, when we come to the fifth unit of output, the average cost is 200. So join all those lines, the average cost we will be getting. So see this average cost. Okay. So see here, average fixed cost means, in order to produce a one unit of output, okay, so the formula for the average fixed cost, total fixed cost is divided by Q, we will be getting as an average fixed cost. So when the output is 0, the average cost will be 1000, okay. Next, when the output started to increase as an 1, the average cost will be 1000. When it comes to 2, when the output is started to increase, the average cost will be started to decline. So that, through that, you just have a diagram. So x-axis represents output and y-axis represents cost. So take it in this manner and draw. The average cost will be an U shape. So average cost will be an U shape, because when the output is keep on increasing, means the cost will be reduced. So that's why average cost is a downward sloping curve. It is a U shape curve. Okay. Now we will move to the average variable cost. So how to find the average variable cost? The same as it is, total variable cost is divided by number of units we will be getting as an average variable cost. Total variable cost is divided by number of units we will be getting as an average variable cost. So now we will see about the average variable cost. Average variable cost means, in order to produce one unit of output, okay, so they have measured from the total variable cost. So average, so how much, in order to produce one unit, what is the average variable cost? So see here, the average variable cost they have taken, see output is 0 to 5 they have taken, and your total variable cost is they have given. So how to find an average variable cost means, total variable cost is divided by Q, we will be getting as an average variable cost. So average variable cost means, in order to produce one unit of output, okay, so how much we have spent on how much alone total variable cost has been used, okay, so how much So that is called as an average variable cost. So total, to find that average variable cost, so total variable cost is divided by Q, we will be getting as an average variable cost. So see here, when the output is zero, total variable cost is also zero. So average cost is also will be zero. When we started to produce one unit, so the total variable cost has been started to incur. It's 200. So in order to produce one unit in variable cost, what is the average? So how much has been spent on variable cost alone, total variable cost alone? So it is 200. So when the cost, when the output is keep on increasing, the total variable cost also is keep on increasing. Okay, but what happens, average variable cost, from the beginning it started to increase, then it started to decrease, and again it started to increase, because the average variable cost will be increased at the when the output will be started to increase. So with the help of this table, we are going to draw a diagram. So average cost will be a U shape. So because when the output is, when the started initial, it is increasing, then it comes to and decreasing, then again it started to increase. So see, measure the values they have taken in a, take as a 100 or 50, take in a 50 manner, because here they have given only up to 200. So take it in 950 terms.
Cost, we will be getting average cost, or else we
option to find an average cost. One is through combined average fixed cost and average variable cost. If we combine, we will be getting average cost, or else divided by total cost. So divided total fixed total cost, which is divided by number of unit, we will be getting as an average cost. Okay, so see, from the beginning here, the total output, total fixed cost, total variable cost, when we combine total fixed cost and total variable cost, we will be getting total cost. To get an average total, that is average total cost, so we have produced a certain goods, that is output. In order to produce one unit, how much we have spent? Okay, in order to produce the first unit, what is the average cost has been spent? So here they have given as an average total cost. How to get this average total cost? Means total cost is divided by number of unit, we will be getting average total cost. Or else average fixed cost plus average variable cost, we will be getting average cost. So see here, the outputs are 0, 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. Then total fixed cost is constant, because during the production, the cost and total fixed cost will not change. Okay, so it will be remains constant, so it is 1000. Next, total variable cost, from the beginning, starting when the output is 0, so total variable cost is also will be 0 only. Because total variable cost is incurred after the production. So total cost will be keep on increasing, because the output, that is the cost will be changes during the production time. So total cost means it combines the total fixed cost and total variable cost, we will be getting total cost. So 1000 plus 0 will be total cost is 1000. So 1000 plus 200, 1200. So we are adding. Next, average total cost means how to find the average total cost. What is average total cost? In order to produce one unit of the commodity, how much has been spent? Okay, that is average total cost. So total cost is divided. So 1000 divided by 0, what we will get? It's infinitive. When it is divided by 0, it will be infinitive. Next, 1200 divided by 1, we will be getting 1200. 1300 divided by 2, we will be getting 650. When 1900 is divided by 5, we will be getting average total cost is 1380. Now, average fixed cost. How to find an average fixed cost? Total fixed cost divided by Q, we will be getting average fixed cost. Average variable cost means total variable cost divided by Q, we will be getting average variable cost. How to get average cost? Either total cost divided by Q, or adding average fixed cost and average variable cost, we will be getting average cost. So see, average total cost the same amount. See here also, average cost is also the same amount will be received. Now we have to draw average total cost. So take the number of unit and only the average total cost. So number of a unit output is 0. Okay. So here I have taken 0 axis. So x axis represents the output and y axis represents cost. Now we will have to see only the average cost, that is average total cost. So when the output is 0, the average cost is also 0. Next, when the output is 1, the average cost is 1200. So 1000, when the output is 1, the average cost is 1200. When the output is 2, the average cost is 650. So between 800 to 600, we will be getting 650. When average cost, when the output is 3, the average cost is 466. So between 400 to 600, we will be getting this value. between 200 to 400 we will get this value. So see here, average an U shape only. So the average of fixed cost and average of variable cost. So average of fixed cost is starting, it will be an U shape. Then average of variable cost in the starting, it will be increased, then it will be declined, and then it comes to again increasing manner. So when average of variable, average of cost is also start, it increasing, then it comes to decreasing. Again when the output is keep on increasing, means the average cost also will be increased. Okay, again a small recap what we saw today. So today we saw about the cost. So what are the cost analysis, that is what are the costs incurred in the production. We saw nearly 8 to 9 cost concepts. So money cost, real cost, explicit cost, implicit cost, then economic cost, sunk cost, social cost, opportunity cost, fluctuating cost, prime cost, fixed cost and variable cost. Then we saw about the short run average cost. So during the short period, so cost will be changes. So what are the types of cost which has been included during the short run production. So total fixed cost and total variable cost, total cost, average fixed cost and average cost. So we saw for each and everything, we saw an individual table and individual diagram, and this is the last one. It shows the entire view of all the things: total fixed cost, total variable cost, total cost and average fixed cost, average variable cost and average cost. Okay, so after this I will stop. In the next class we will see about the marginal cost and other cost. Okay, relationship between marginal cost and we will see about the long run average cost curve. Okay, thank you students. So copy this everything in your classwork. So separately I need a diagram and table. Okay, thank you.